Well, it's a great pleasure to stand before great people like you. Amen. I've come to realize to say, for you, God is the Father to the fatherless. God, He has given me a father whom I never thought I could have a father like my father, Bishop Stephen Nkata. Shall we clap our hands together for our daddy? You know, I can say I am what you see me to be because of my dad. I can boast about this, and because this is true. I'm just somebody who never knew anything, coming from somewhere where nothing good can come out of me. But when I came here, my daddy saw something, said, I see something in this boy. And let me nurture that which is in this boy. And for you, we nurture that which was in that boy. And that which was in that boy, it is growing bigger and bigger. Shall we again put our hands together for our daddy? Amen. Allow me as well to recognize the presence of Pastor Chihuahua. He's been my good father. He's been there for me. He's always there for me. Whenever I call him daddy, this and that, he is always there for me. Amen. Shall we clap our hands together for Pastor Chihuahua? Not only that, I have another father. My father, whenever I have gone wrong, he will pick up the call and say, Sonny, come here. So not that, I'm just come here. Amen. And no matter what, I'll just need to be in his office. His name is nothing other than Pastor Wadia. Shall we put our hands together for Pastor Wadia? Amen. Also, I want to recognize the presence of Mrs. Mae. She's been a good mother to me as well. Amen. Shall we put our hands together for Mrs. Mae? Not forgetting you yourself. You are precious people, as I cannot manage to be mentioning one by one for the sake of time. Shall we put our hands together for ourselves? Amen. Before I go any further, when I was told to say you'll be ministering, I refused, in fact, to say, I know, I cannot manage. So they say, I said, okay, if it's like that, make me, just put me back. Because that, I have never stood there to preach. So I can't stand to preach there. But they just don't know, the time has come for you to minister. So as I stand here, I cannot minister without getting the blessings from my father. Father, allow me as I come down for you to pray for me. Amen. Amen.
Inside your son. You that knows God from your word, whom you choose to bless, and whom you choose to lift, and whom you choose to anoint. And we know that God, when it comes to that area, we have no contribution. Our only work is to acknowledge what you have done. We thank you for the life of this man. I pray that God, this bold step of faith that he takes today, it is an announcement in the spiritual realm and an opening of things that have been locked up years and generations right from his bloodline. A new generation is being born. Lord, I bless him as a father blesses a son. I release that anointing over his life, that from today you are lifted to stand before learned men, learned women, to stand before businessmen, to stand before politicians, to stand before different various platforms of media. I set forth on this platform with power and the glory of God. May the Lord use you according to how he has prepared you. Heavenly Father, magnify yourself through him. Let even his weakness seem to be his strength this morning. In the name of Jesus Christ, Heavenly Father, show your pride through him this morning as you rejoice as he speaks your word. thank you for the entire youth and all that they have done this morning. The magnificent service we have had. All glory and honor belongs to you. It is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 14. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 14. Give me KJV. KJV. But continue thou in the things which thou hast learned and hast been assured of, knowing of whom thou hast learned them. There is a need of continue. It starts with continue. This was the time when Apostle Paul was admonishing his son in faith called Timothy. He said, Timothy, my son, continue in these things which I am teaching you, because there will come other people who are going to teach you something that will be contrary from these things which I am teaching you. But as for you, continue in these which I am teaching you. Next. Next. And that from a child thou hast known the Holy Scripture, and that from youth thou hast known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through faith which is in Christ Jesus. Next. All Scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. So he gives us a borderline where the Scripture, they profit us. He says, the Scripture, they profit us in the way of doctrine. Now, doctrine, it means learning. Doctrine, it means teaching. Meaning, Scriptures are there for us to learn. Scriptures are there for teaching to us. Again, he says, all Scripture are given for the proof. The way the proof there is evidence, is conviction, whereby whenever you find yourself in a situation, the situation says this and the Scripture says that. You've got to go by what the Scripture says. Why? Because Scriptures, they are a proof. Scriptures, they are a proof. Apart from Scriptures, we do not have proof. Amen. Apart from Scriptures, we don't have proof. Now, anywhere we go, you can attest to this. Elders, they keep on saying this generation is lost, or this generation has gone astray. This generation has gone astray. What has made this generation to go astray? Answers are there in the Bible. James chapter 1 verse 16. This generation has gone astray. The Scripture says, do not err, my beloved brethren. Do not err, my beloved youths. Do not err, my beloved elders. Do not err, everyone. Do not err. Now, that word error, it means to wander from the right path, to wander from the right way, to go away from the correct way. Now, the question which we should ask ourselves is, why do people err? Why do people err? The reason why people err, Scriptures must interpret themselves. Give me Matthew chapter 22, verse 29. Matthew chapter 22, verse 29. Matthew chapter 22, verse 29. Why is it that people err? Jesus, he now gave us an answer as to why people err. Jesus answered and said unto them, ye do err, not knowing the Scriptures, nor the power of God. So it means any time as youth we move away from the Scriptures, we err. Remember, Scriptures are given for correction. Any time we wander away from the Scriptures, we err. Remember, the Scriptures action, when we know what the word of God says concerning that beauty. Amen. Colossians chapter 1, verse 9. Colossians chapter 1, verse 9. We can only build the nation when we know what scriptures says concerning us. For this cause, we also, since the day we heard it, do not cease to pray for you and to desire that ye might be filled with the knowledge of his will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding. The prayer of Apostle Paul was that you may be filled with the knowledge of who? The knowledge of God. Why? Because when we are filled with the knowledge of God, we are filled with the knowledge of who we are. Because we are only revealed in him. Outside him, we don't know ourselves. When Jesus Christ is revealed, that's when we are revealed. When Jesus is revealed, that's when our capability is revealed. When Jesus is revealed, that's when our potential is revealed. Anything that reveals you, apart from the scripture, it is not a new you. Only the scripture has the audacity to review us. Why? Because they are for the proof. Anything that does not agree with the scripture, it is not us. Amen. See, I pray for you that you may be filled. Next. That ye might walk well of the Lord. To all pleasing. So now, as a youth, we can only walk worthy when we know him. When we know him, when we know scriptures, when we know what scripture says concerning us, we shall walk worthy. Any walking worthy outside the scriptures, it is not worthy at all. Amen. We can only walk worthy of the Lord. That's why you cannot go to a sinner and start telling a sinner, stop sinning. He don't have what it takes to stop sinning. The only thing to present to a sinner is the word of Christ. The word of Christ will give the ability to that sinner to stop sinning. So when we have the word, we shall be able to walk worthy. Amen.
Doing well.
As I am concluding, James chapter 1, verse 22. 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 The scripture says, but be ye doers of the word, and not hearers only, deceiving your own self. Continue. For if any be a hearer of the word, and not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his natural face in a glass. For he beholdeth himself, and goeth his way, and straightway forgotteth what manner of man he was living there. I used to wonder at school, anytime it is near to knock off, I will see ladies, they will get into their handbags, they will get mirrors, they will begin to clean themselves. They begin to clean themselves. And then I realize and say, show me a beautiful lady, I will show you a lady who values a mirror. A lady who values a mirror. What is the mission of the mirror? The mission of the mirror is to reflect you to you. The mission of the mirror is to make you make some adjustments. The mission of the mirror is to make you look at yourself. Now, for he beholdeth himself and goeth his way and straightway forgotteth what manner of man he was, not he is, he was. Meaning, this person, when he went into the mirror, he saw another object. When he left the mirror, he saw another object. Now, what makes it to be like that? But whoso looketh into the perfect law of liberty and continueth therein, he being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the way, this man shall be blessed in all his deeds. Continue. Just back. But whosoever continueth. We started with where Apostle Paul was telling Timothy, continue. And this one said, whosoever continueth. Continuing what? Looking into the mirror. Which one is the mirror? The word of God. If you want to be used, scripture. It is like a lady who goes into a mirror and she begins to pound herself. She begins to pound herself. Or maybe she is late where she's going. So she just did fast. 2 minutes left. Along the way, if she meets somebody who tells her to say, hey, sister, wait. Your powder is not balanced. The other part is thick. She will start cleaning. Even though that person is making a caricature of that lady, she will start cleaning. Why? She's not sure of what she saw. But I'm talking about a lady who spent time looking herself into the mirror, and she's even sure of what she saw. When she walks out of that mirror, she meets a person, and that person tells her to say, your makeup is not balanced. Your powder is not balanced. She will say, shut up. I saw myself. I know who I am. So if we are to be youths of influence, we should continue in the scriptures. Amen. Amen. God bless you. Amen. I call upon my father to come and take over for me.
Which means that the youth have done a wonderful work. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You have done well, and you must be proud of yourself. The only thing when the Lord does things like this, one continue to walk in humility, always not considering that you are above other people, and always ready to learn from other people. When you are standing in that kind of position, we are always servants. We are always the ones that are below, and we regard everyone above them. If you take that spirit, not even the sky is the limit, because God then is going to use you mightily. He does not just use the talented man. He uses the man that the Holy Spirit has worked on him, and he has the character of Christ. Amen.
Amen.
So let's clap for him one more time. Thank you so much. You can take your seat. Pastor Matthews, may I be late to